It's late on a Saturday night at the Gateway Playhouse, and the stage crew is about to put on a cool show just before one of their coolest shows.
The beginning of rehearsal for our ice show is Monday. We actually need to create an ice rink so that we can be skating on Monday morning.
The actual performances won't be held at the Gateway, so why not rehearse at a local ice rink?
It's more convenient because we hold all of our rehearsals here, and we have to do lighting and sound and scenery and all the normal things we do in a show.
Years ago, they put on so many ice shows that they actually purchased their own ice-making equipment.
And now it's been a long time since we've done ice, so we're really excited to bring an ice show back to Long Island, and the reaction so far has been great. And we're getting that fresh reaction we got the first time we did it. Like, wow, how could you do ice? Like, how are you gonna freeze the stage?
Yeah, how are you gonna freeze the stage?
We prepare the stage by just cleaning it. Then we put a wooden rim around the whole area, which will be the perimeter of the ice rink. And then we lay down a protective liner of 6 mil plastic. We lay down 2-inch foam.
The foam has a dual purpose. It levels out the floor so that there's a smooth surface to put the mats on, and it protects the ice from any heat that rises from the basement.
Another layer of plastic gets laid down, and then the final step would be to put in the rubber mats.
The mats are actually a series of rubber tubes that are rolled out the width of the stage. Then another's rolled out, and another's rolled out, and the process is repeated until the stage is completely covered. The mats are connected to feeder tubes, which are then connected to 2-inch hoses. Those hoses go backstage, out the building, and into a massive chilling unit in the parking lot.
This is the chiller that makes the ice for the Gateway Playhouse ice show. Well, these are compressors. These are pumps down here. This is the barrel where all the glycol recirculates.
Glycol is just a fancy name for antifreeze. Glycol remains liquid at 11 degrees Fahrenheit.
This is the condenser, which would get rid of all the heat we've taken from inside on the mats and brings it outside into the air.
As the glycol flows through the mats, the team checks for leaks. With the unit maintaining pressure, it's time to start making ice.
You can't just fill it with water and wait for it to freeze. It would never happen. You actually water it with a garden hose, and it's little layer by layer. So you water it, you wait about 10 or 15 minutes, the water you put down is now frozen, you water it again, you wait 15 minutes, you water it again, and it takes about 12 hours.
The next day, the stage is covered with 3 inches of fresh ice, ready for the first rehearsal. It's at this point that the team decides how cold to keep the ice.
The skaters like the ice to have a little bit of give to it, so they don't want it too cold, because then it gets brittle, and when they land, they could feel the difference between 11 degree ice and 8 degree ice.
Surprisingly, all this work building a stage is just for a few days of rehearsal.
We do have our one full week of rehearsal here. It's all they're gonna get. And then we get into Patchogue Theater on Sundays. 4 o'clock, we're stopping rehearsal, and by midnight, we've gotta set this up in Patchogue, and we've got about 18 hours to turn it around, and we'll be skating in Patchogue any day now.
Thank you.